Hello, Deployment Insiders, and welcome back to another episode here in Building 36, home of the Office Engineering Team, where in each episode, I'll bring you tips, tricks, and best practices to make your office deployment easier. And in today's episode, I'm going to show you about a new admin role that will help provide restrictive access to config.office.com and the M365 Admin Center, along with an update on some new features available within config.office.com. So let's get started. We've been working on some new features that will help improve your Office app management capabilities. And this month, I want to touch up upon several new features to help make management of Office deployment easier. Now, the first new feature focuses on how you gain access or authorization to config.office.com. So we've heard from a lot of you, especially in the larger organizations, that you have some kind of Exchange Online or SharePoint Online team that won't even give you access to any of the portals or services because it actually require you to have a global admin rights or other rights that just won't pertain to you. Now, in a world where security is paramount, there's a need for a reduced number of users with obviously global admin privileges. And thus, we now have introduced a new role called the Office Apps Administrator role. Now, this role is going to grant you access to all of the Office app admin services that are now available in config.office.com. And what I mean by this is that you'll have the right to build configuration files, save them to the cloud, or even have the ability to create cloud policies for Office apps. And over the next year, you're going to start seeing more and more functionality being added to config.office.com. And this role will give you access to be able to use that. We've had a number of admins also ask access to the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. Now, this role actually gives you the right to just go read everything in the Admin Center, with the exception of the What's New capabilities that I talked about, and I'll link that into the video below. Now, for example, let's say you want to read the latest Message Center post, or you want to create a service request, you'll actually have those capabilities as well. And all of this has been documented, and again, I'll post a link down below and show you an example of exactly what that looks like. And finally, this role also is PIM enabled for those of you who want the extra security measures to provide just-in-time access. Now, trust me, your security and AAD teams will be really happy about this. So now let's talk about how to get this thing set up. To get going, you're going to need to work with someone in your organization who has global admin privileges to give you access to the new Office Apps admin role. What you're going to want to do is go to the left navigation, click on roles. And once this comes up, you can scroll down, click on the Office Apps admin role. You could see some information about it. I can even click on learn more, see how many folks have been assigned and what category this belongs to. And here, if I click on the admins assigned, you could see the list of administrators that I have right now and some of the permissions that are available. Now, if you really want to go deep into every single nuance of this particular role, what you want to be able to do is go directly into portal.azure.com. And then under the Azure Active Directory, let's go down into roles. And furthermore, from here, I can actually do a quick search, type in Office, hit enter. And you can see that this is flagged as a recently introduced role. From here, I'm going to go and see the description. So this actually gives you the granular information of all of these individual roles, what the permissions are, what are some of the basic read permissions and so forth. This is great documentation that allow your security operations or your Active Directory team to be able to really understand what kind of access that you will have. Again, this will give you full access to anything in config.office.com, or it will give you mainly read-only access into the main admin center or the Microsoft 365 admin center, as we now call it. And then it will give you some additional capabilities. For example, if you do want to go ahead and open a service request, you can actually do that by going into new service request and being able to continue and work through that. So there are a couple of different ways to be able to assign admin roles. I can go into my users, click on active users, and give that person a particular admin, you'll see that I have a test admin right here. I could say manage roles, and you could see, you know, where I can check or uncheck that box right there. There's always so many different ways of being able to add and grant users those set of permissions and be able to move on from there. One thing I do want to show you as well, we talked about PIM earlier, where I can go manage in PIM if I clicked on that. And if you do have the right set of licenses and subscriptions available for using PIM, this will take you that information and get you all signed up and set up from there. So great things from there. We hope that new capability now gives you a better security posture in order to ensure that you don't have a lot of global administrators within your organization, and therefore you'll now have access, more scoped access to config.office.com. So now let's switch over to a net new feature that we've recently introduced, which is the security baseline. The Office team recently released a new set of security baseline, which is a set of policies going back to, you know, who knows, longer than I've been around in the Office team. Now, these policies are recommendations from our security specialists and have been adopted, configured, and deployed by many of our customers. In fact, we have continuously been asked by customers to add these new policies to the new policy management features in config.office.com. The good news is that our team got that feedback and we've started developing the security baseline directly into policy management features. So let me kind of just show you how that looks like, how you can tweak it and be able to deploy that out. Once I log into config.office.com, of course, with the now new Office app admin role or global administrator role, depending on what you have to sign in, let me go ahead and go down into policy management. And from here, I can look at an existing policy management, or I can go ahead and create a new one. Let's, for this demo, let's go ahead and create a new one. I'm just gonna call this HR policies, test policies for HR. I'm gonna have to click on assignment. What we wanna do is pick this policy configure applies to the particular set of users. And I can select a group, and I'm gonna go ahead and do I even have a test one? If not, I'm just gonna pick the sub A as an example. And then we're gonna move on into config policy. Now this is where you're able to start seeing all of the new policies as we start loading this. Now what you're gonna see is a new column here called recommendation. If I went ahead and clicked on that and I just clicked on security baseline and filter, now I can see every single policy that is tagged as a security baseline policy. Now you can see there are total 87 policies across 5 pages. Now I can see a new recommendation tab. And what this does, if I go ahead and click on that down arrow, click on security baseline and then filter, it now gives me a total of about 87 policies, which are all security baseline associated. I can go through each and every one of these and go ahead and start configuring them or actually use the Microsoft recommended security baseline addition there. Click on OK, it's now configured. And once I'm done with that, I can go ahead and click on Create. And that's it from there. Now I have the security baseline associated with this group. And so the next time any user within this group goes ahead and signs in or turns on a new Office app, all these security baseline policies will go ahead and be applied onto those devices. And that's pretty much it. So tell us, what do you think about the security baseline? Are you gonna be using it? Do you actually implement security baseline today? Let us know in the comments below. Now, lastly, I wanna show you something that we've also added in the past several months. It's called the Service Health Dashboard. The goal here is to provide you with an extra peace of mind to ensure that all the services that you're seeing in config.office.com are up and running and working the most efficiently. If for any reason one of our services degrades in performance or functionality, we'll post an alert onto this page. In fact, when you sign in, we'll automatically expand the notification pane so you're not always searching and seeing whether something has changed. Now, as you can see in this particular instance, this is all production live services, so we have nothing going on, so everything looks good here. But if we did have anything, you would start seeing issues. We would start providing you with information as we are investigating, troubleshooting, and deploying any fixes that would be necessary. And that is it for this episode. We hope you enjoy these new features. Let us know what you think in the comments below. As always, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and notification icon to know when we release new videos. Also, if you have any topics that you want to hear on this channel or have a feature that you would like for us to build, head on over to the User Voice site. If you want to continue the discussion about this or any other Office-related deployment topics, head over to our tech community site where you'll be able to chat with me and a member of our engineering team and other IT admins from around the world. As always, we'll add the links to the description below. I hope to see you there. Until then, keep on deploying.